What do you want?
With the whetstone and hammer you've retrieved for us, Brock and I can construct the Dvegrathikr, dwarven armor of legend.
We just need three more mythical ingredients before we set to hammer.
Which are?
Dunno. Armor's pure legend, and the details is fuzzier than a wolver's butthole.
You expect us to find parts from a legend?
Oh, Motsognir, the dwarf king, found two of them. Everyone knows that. But when he went looking for the third,
poof, he vanished. Maybe he'll find some clues at his stronghold in Konungsgard.
And looky here, a Konungsgard entry stone. It's got your name on it. How fucking strange. The stronghold's northwest of here, behind the Svartalfheim Realm Tower.
Large stone structure, creepy atmosphere. You'll know it when you see it. The Huldra brothers, back in action again. Oh, I can't wait to get started.
Never think I'd see such a day we was back to building as a duo. But it feels right, especially for this. Been so used to building on my own all these years, almost forgot how dang useful an extra pair of hands is.
I forgot how much easier it is to smelt scap slag with someone else gauging the temperature.
This'll be our best work yet. Just need a little help from you lot.
Something else we can do for you?
Nah, just glad you guys worked it out.
Ah. Well, I could say the same to you.
I guess I was getting a bit full of myself.
Told him what he needed to hear, how's it sounds to me.
Just the same. I'm sorry for how I spoke to you, Sindri. You forgive me?
Already have. Like you said, it all worked out. Now, let us get back to work before I get sentimental.
Now we just need to figure out what door this key opens. It has to be somewhere around the temple. Key, we can open that big door anytime you want. Let's explore. Namir, why did you say Tyr felt responsible for what Odin did to the giants?
There was an incident shortly after the forging of Mjolnir, when Tyr arranged a diplomatic meeting between Odin and the giant kings. Well, this was when the Long War was young, and victory was still a thing dreamed of, and the Jotnar might have tipped the balance between Aesir and Vanir. Odin had persuaded Tyr that the hammer was merely a deterrent, a means to broker peace from a position of strength. Tyr was hopeful to convince all parties they would prosper best through peace. He knew the giants were deeply concerned about the hammer, a super weapon in hands they did not trust, but they trusted Tyr. Tyr always believed the best in people, and taking Odin at his word in his desire for peace, he brought the Raven King to Jotunheim. From there, things unraveled quickly. The giants anticipated Odin's trickery and exposed his true agenda to spy and steal their secret wisdom. With magics, they expelled Odin from their realm and cursed him never to return. Frustrated, Odin visited his fury upon the giants of Midgard. Thor unleashed Mjolnir's might upon any giant he could find. None could stand against the tide of slaughter that followed. And at last, it seems, with Tyr's aid, they retreated. The tower disappeared, no giants could be found in Midgard, and no man nor god has set foot in Jotunheim since.
Oh!
says, glory to Motsignir, the Dwarf King.
May his reign be long, prosperous, and filled with peace.
Greetings, and welcome to Konungsgard. I just want to make sure you're good and prepared before heading in any further. There's all manner of nastiness left over from the Mad Dwarf King's foul practices.
What kind of practices?
Oh, various sacrificing, dark enchantments, blood, magic, and so forth. Quite common among the older dwarves, unfortunately. Old habits are hard to break.
It's another dragon.
I see it, boy.
Chain.
I hope we can find the binding shrines. This place is huge.
Ready yourself, boy.
Captured more than one dragon. He must have needed them to create this legendary armor.
Interesting thought, lad. And it makes sense. Nearly everything about dragons is useful and contains power. Teeth, scales, even excrement.
Excrement?
Shit!
Dragon shit is powerful?
Aye, lad. Potently powerful.
Mad is having fun with you.
Oh, I knew that.
Legendary armor better be worth the trouble.
But if Brock and Sindri make it together, I'm sure it's worth the effort. Don't you trust them, at least?
I trust you, Atreus. I do not trust the legend.
Oh.
A few ways to find out, but they're rather messy.
You make quite a formidable duo.
You'd think this dragon would be a bit more supportive, seeing how we're trying to free it.
Huh.
Look here.
Sir. Huh. Neat.
Vast.
I wonder what happened to him.
There's a great mystery, even amongst the sons of Ivaldi. Mozognir's behavior before his disappearance grew increasingly erratic. But the Devegrath Eater, the very armor you find yourself searching for. Though he found two, I'd wager his failure to find the third ingredient drove him to madness. Hey.
Oh!
These are strong here. Keep your guard up.
Why did the Dwarf King want this armor so badly? What's so special about it?
There are many legends behind the Dvay Grathekar. A suspicious amount of legends, which makes confirming anything about this particular armor difficult. But the one constant among them is the ability of the armor to offer ultimate protection. A useful attribute for an unpopular king, you see.
Yet this plagued land is all that remains of him. This is why you do not trust legends, boy.
Well, what can you trust?
Yourself, your eyes, your instincts. Blind trust in a legend is a gamble, and rarely does it pay off.
If you say so. Here we go. It's kind of run down.
What did you expect? Another one here.
Stargather. Wow. That's a lot of arms.
That's fair to say.
6, 7, 8? Could he shoot 4 bows at once?
More of a swordsman. He did only have the 2 eyes.
It looks like Thor cut him down to size.
It's what he does.
Do you hear that?
No. What do you hear, boy?
Crying. And screams. They're getting louder. They sound almost like... Hellwalker!
Don't this up, boy!
That was a lot of Hellwalkers. Hey, look at this!
A blood trail.
Where's the passage behind this throne?
A secret passage!
Well, wouldn't be a proper throne room without a secret passage.
Signir.
Roy, over here.
Huh. Interesting. I may want to write that down. The things you pulled from him. Those must be the three mythical ingredients Brock was talking about.
I can say with utmost certainty that I've never laid eye on a stranger set of objects in my life.
How are Brock and Sindri supposed to build with whatever they are?
Don't count the dwarves out, lad. They're right pricks, but they're resourceful. They once made an unbreakable chain out of little more than a cat's footstep and bird spit.
That doesn't even make sense.
Well, that's the legend. If you wanted sense, you shouldn't be talking to a severed head.
This place looked like in better times.
Conan'sGard was a beautiful land in its heyday, before the Dwarf King's obsession poisoned his mind.
How could he let that happen?
The Dwarf blindly trusted in the legend and pursued it without thought to the consequences. This is the result.
This is a gamble. Like you said, the Dwarf King lost. I always heard that Baldur's mother was Frigg.
Aye, Frigg. Well, that's more of a pet name, you see. It means beloved. Something Odin called Freya after they wed. Out of affection at first, or so I like to believe. As things turned sour, it became a way to manipulate the truth. Odin didn't want Freya, a Vanir goddess, getting credit for anything in Asgard. So anything worthy she accomplished was attributed to Frigg. That's right. Freya was Baldur's mother all along.
So weird. How do you build a piece of armor out of something so
Nanya.
Nanya?
Nanya fucking business. Trade secret. We got our ways.
Oh.
To work it is.
What was the other thing?